Now on four, the tube.
I can now reveal that you, as a Channel 4 viewer, research as proof beyond any doubt whatsoever that you are far better than the average scumbag who would watch the other channels. However, some people have not been watching the tube as often as they might, and they've been missing things like... If you are going to miss it this Friday, then video it. And if you don't video it, then we're not interested in you. Go away.
What that man does in his bedroom with his new teas made, but we...
...scenes from the next attraction to play this theater. This picture, truly one of the most unusual ever filmed, contains scenes which under no circumstances should be viewed by anyone with a heart condition or anyone who is easily upset. We urgently recommend that if you are such a person or the parent of a young or impressionable child now in attendance, that you and the child... leave the auditorium.
Give me a tea! 2.
Looking for an excuse for the past 8 weeks to play this. Got it at last. It's Jeff Beck and Star Cycle. It's funny, he's taken a new television channel to get the balance right as far as Belfast concerned. I hope the tube managed to tip it in the right direction. Jeff Beck and the theme tune.
Myself as another Duran, you know, look at me.
I think that the tube in Belfast, when it wrote about it, said it was magnificent and foolhardy, which may sound a very grand phrase, but it's a superb gesture coming over to cover Northern Ireland because it will inject enthusiasm where perhaps before there was little. At the same time, if that is all that the tube does and if that is all people see, they Friday night will watch Belfast and forget about it, then nothing has been achieved.
Best of the Tube.
I don't know.
Airplanes, parachuting, gun clubs, any sort of clubs you could name it. Everything's there, everything you could wish for is here.
Well, it's happening in LA nowadays, you know.
And we are actually lucky enough to have Pete Townshend himself here in the studio with us. What do you think, then, looking at that film? What do you think of that?
What, the Roger Daltrey show?
Yeah.
Oh, that was very good, yeah. There were three other members in the band, you know?
Oh.
This is Roger in his blue period.
Is it? You don't like that too much of him on screen, not enough for you.
I didn't actually like Woodstock very much, so it kind of brings back bad memories for me, yeah.
What was it like? I mean,
horrible.
It was a long time ago. So what, because it's so big?
It was a lot of Americans congratulating themselves on the fact that this festival was going to change the world, and I kind of saw through it. I realised that it was a...
Well, even when you were there?
Yeah. So there's a lot of political stuff going on in the background, and people like Abby Hoffman, who I kicked off the stage, because he came on in the middle of the act and started to give people lectures. And, I don't know, it was like a very self-congratulatory affair, you know.
Yeah. Look what we're doing, sort of thing. Yeah. Isn't it wonderful?
Sort of much like everybody is here today.
Yeah, aren't we good? Yeah.
How about change the world, folks, this programme.
Oh, no, it's not designed to do. What do you think of television? I mean, this isn't designed to change the world so much as Channel 4.
Oh, well, I'm going in. what do I think of what? Rock television?
Yeah, or music on television.
Well, I've really got high hopes for this programme and any that like it, that it sparks off. I think that there's never been enough space on TV for music. I mean, England and the base of England as a centre for music from all around the world has always been incredibly volatile and active, and what have we had? Like one programme basically that's lasted a long time, which is record, you know, which is charts based. Programmes like Ready Steady Go, which were so great in their time, don't exist anymore, and I just think the more music there is on television, the better. I just think you need a tremendous amount of it because there's so many great bands that need airtime.
Because I saw on Newsnight that you were on the other night, and a film of you in Shea Stadium, and it struck me, it's from that film. I don't know if you've seen that film since.
No, I was over there.
Oh, yeah. But it struck me that you really had sort of had enough of it all, and of just playing live and stuff, and also had enough of Americans. Would that be the right impression?
The Shea Stadium thing was very weird because it was like a very big deal, about 100,000 people for two nights in a great big stadium, and a lot of fuss and a lot of excitement. And I mean, strangely enough, for Who, I've got a very young audience in America still. A lot of people had never seen us before, so it was kind of exciting, but it is something that we've been doing for a long time. And for me, a lot of the kick has gone out of it. So I feel, I don't know, it's not I'm jaded or anything. I still really love to play and I still love to perform, but I would prefer to be doing something new. Mm. So however exciting the event was, there's a shade of cynicism in me that sort of says, you know, all mouth and no trousers, you know. It's like, unless you actually go on the stage and you get some kind of musical kick and fulfillment from it, I don't know. It was great to do, you know.
Mm. So what, I mean, what are you going to do now then? I mean,
me?
Yeah.
I'm just going to sit back and for a bit and think about what to do next. I am going to, I think, get out of rock and roll for a bit. I'm a bit disenchanted with it at some levels, but I listen,
is it the music
what
or the attitude?
I do doesn't really matter, I don't think, anymore. It's like, I think, you know, I'm, one of the things that I love about Britain is the amount of new music that there is around. That's why I find America so frustrating, is that a band like The Who are still so incredibly important, you know, when there's so many new things around that don't get an airing. I think that's going to change. I want to do new stuff. I'm really happy about what The Who has done, and happy to look back at it on video. But, you know, I just...
I thought it was only a little
bit
of you,
innit?
I want
to become a bank manager.
Yeah?
Think,
yeah, not a bad idea. Loads of dough, innit? Well, I mean, there's, you've seen the... Do you think there's any parallels between you and the Jam?
There are some... There were some when we first started, but, I think the only parallels are are in the fact that the Jam are modernist oriented,
yeah.
And the Who went through a modernist period, but certainly we weren't really as true to modernist ideals as the Jams seem to be.
Yeah. Man over there is just going like that, which means we have to...
It means get off.
No, no, it doesn't mean get off, but it means we can quickly show this book, yeah, this book, which is you obviously published as well as contributed.
Yeah. Right, it's the Morgan Mongers on television.
Hello, Paula. Yes. Have you met Pete? It's taller.
Hello, Pete.
I'm Jools, don't mind me.
Nice to meet both of you. All three of you.
Isn't it?
On the Tube from now on, we're going to be showing each week a different unknown band or bands. It's pretty unusual for a lot of these bands to get on the telly. In fact, so...
I know how he feels about that. Anyway, right, moving on. That's from the Duran Duran video, which will be available next year, so you can all rush out and buy that when it comes out. Right, Fresh, just before he zaps off to Montserrat to do the new Police album, Andy Summers is with us. Hi, Andy. If I could, I've taken all this PA equipment out the back of my pocket so I can sit on the comfy chairs. How are you?
Not bad.
Triff. Right, you've got a new album coming out, which... no, it's out already, isn't it?
It is out, yeah.
Yeah, with Robert Fripp, and it's called...
I Advance Masked.
What's the gen behind that title of the album? Has it got any significance, or what made you decide to call it that?
Well, actually, this title was one that we had pinned up on the wall last summer in Montserrat when we recorded, amongst myriad other titles. In the front of a book by Salvador Dali, but it was a phrase that I thought was particularly applicable to modern life, especially if you live in the rock world, where I think you need to maybe have a persona, which is a kind of mask, so that you can go on and not get too screwed up by the machinations of the rock industry.
And the album's got a great cover, actually, which we can get a look at if we stretch over here. Tell me, that's a great cover, an album cover. Can we see it there if I hold it still somewhat? Would you like to tell us a bit about that, the artwork, because it's fab.
There's a lot of effort in it. Yeah, this cover was done by a New York artist called Jimmy Rizzi, who's previously did an album sleeve for the Tom Club. He's actually a mate of mine, and he did me a Police album about 4 years ago, which we haven't used as yet. But this is a piece of artwork that I have at home, so I was really...
Yeah, it's a terrific cover. What about the actual combination of Robert Fripp and Andy Summers? Because to me,
It immediately appeared to me to be a rather strange combination for me, knowing you with your police work with the police. How did that come about? How did you get to meet Robert?
It may seem strange in the fact that we really are on two different ends of the rock spectrum, I suppose. But I think really that's what makes it work. We're so unlike, maybe, as personalities, and even guitar players. We, you know, very different ways of playing and approaching playing the guitar, which I think manages to make it work, because there's a kind of tension there of trying to come together to make your music work. And I think that really is true of any good group music experience. It's when people are really different that the effort to come together to make the music is what.
And do you think that this will affect your future solo musical outlook on things, you know, if you go on to do other solo work or what, as opposed to the work you do with the police? How do you think that this album will?
Well, it's difficult to say specifically what's going to happen, but I think all these experiences colour you along the way.
Well, we've got a bit of the video which you made to go with it coming up shortly, but also I was having a quick look at it earlier on, and there's kind of exotic dancers or what have you. Did you have anything to do with the background to that as well?
During the day we did, yes.
I'm not talking about what you did with the dancers. I mean, what? How about, did you, I mean, said, shut up, you lot, I'm doing this. And I mean, they're kind of dancing around doing exotic things, but is that to do with the music, or is it totally, you know, sort of just to make everything look?
Well, I think it's in the eye of the beholder. I mean, originally those girls were going to be musicians, but we preferred to have them dancing around with almost nothing on in the end. It was more exciting for Robert and I.
Disgusting, it is. Well, what about the future police work that's coming out? What about the new album in Montserrat?
Yeah, well, we're counting down now. The days are finally going away until we go off to Montserrat. We're leaving on November the 30th, and we have 6 weeks there, and then we go from that tropical climate up to Montreal in the depth of winter to finish it off.
I say, well, with Duran Duran out east and you going out to Montserrat and whatever, I have to make do with Hastings in October, but maybe things will change in the future. I'm going to get...
Not for you.
Well, I'm going to go... thank you very much. I'm going to go over in a minute... shut up, you lot. I'm going to go over in a minute and put on a cassette, because you have to do everything for yourself, Andy, as you might have noticed. Demarcation, but never mind. And we'll see a bit of your video, so up we go. Where is it? Oh, here it is. Right, I slam it in. Thanks very much, Andy, by the way. I just thought I'd throw that in there. Shove it in. Push the button. And with a bit of luck, coming up in about 3 seconds should be Andy Summers.
But you can tell that this is live television because I am sitting on my foot, because I wasn't allowed to go to the loo before the show started. However, there are so many girls on tonight's show that even the crew came out of the pub early, and the whole place has the overpoweringly erotic smell of Brute. Later tonight, we've got the all-girl American band, the Go-Go's, and to get you ready, here are lots of sequined-covered wobbly bits, and we see three clips of all-girl groups from the 60s.
Three-dimensional vision! Well, tonight on the weights in your ass. Tonight on the tube, we have a 3D. We're going to move over this way and we're going to hand out these. And if you've got these at home, three-dimensional glasses in the TV Times. One for you. £3 each. Pay me later. £3 each. We've got to get over to the camera. Now, we're going to actually see, not a lot with those ones. Let's just, well, we'll leave those to be handed out. We'll just take a pair over to the camera over here. As you can see, it's a bit live. Yes, all right. It's like the Black Hole of Calcutta, isn't it? Right, it's in Delhi. Now, you'll notice that even the cameraman himself on camera number one is wearing these. Excuse me, can I just put these down? So it means what we're going to be seeing here is actually going to be in three dimension. We can put them on the front of the telly. Remember, if you've got these indoors, get them out. First ever time on British television, you're going to be seeing three dimension.
Well, it's still here.
Thank you. focus, Alex.
Welcome to the Best of the Tube, the 80th... energy, all that. Don't smile, pull, work.